I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please note that this meeting is being made available to the public through a live video and audio broadcast on Comcast Government Access Channel 15, and is being recorded for broadcast at future dates. Comments made in open session will be recorded. We have one announcement from the Town Clerk's Office, Mary Ann Smith. A special town meeting will be held on October 18th, 2016, at 7 p.m. at the Pembroke High School on Learning Lane. The last day to register to vote at the special town meeting is Wednesday, September 28th, 2016. The town clerk's office will be open until 8 p.m. for that purpose only. A second announcement from the clerk's office. Wednesday, October 19th, 2016 is the last day to register to vote for the November 8th presidential election. The town clerk's office will be open until 8 p.m. for that purpose only. If you have any further questions, please feel free to contact the town clerk's office at 781-709-1403. Thank you. Before we begin, I'd like to recognize some members of the Fisheries Commission who have come to visit us this evening. They will be going to another meeting, so I'm going to let them come forward and tell us why they're here. And I'll turn it over to Selectman Bolter, if I may.
Okay. This is under old business. That would come under the fisheries in regards to last Thursday night the fisheries had a meeting, and Arthur is the assistant superintendent of the fisheries, and he would like to make a request to the Board of Selectmen from our meeting from last Thursday. The other thing that I would like to do is have the board give these guys an attaboy, because these three and the other members of the board that couldn't make it here tonight have done a lot of work in the last 3 years, really over and beyond cleaning the streams and fixing dams and doing whatever else that needed to be done, and working hand-to-hand with the Division of Marine Fisheries and also Brockton Water, and trying to get all of our heron up safely to migrate, and also for the juvenile heron to get down in the spring, in the fall. So I'd like to have the board recognize these guys, and also they would like to make a request of the board, if you would.
Gentlemen, we would like to bring on a junior commissioner, and it's Bill's grandson. I'm sorry, I don't remember his name.
Yeah, right. Jack Bolter.
Jack, what's his last name?
Bolter.
Oh, Bolter, okay. Jack Bolter. I'd like to bring Jack Bolter on as a junior commissioner. If anyone has any problems with that, you can hear them now, but I don't think there will be.
I think it's a good idea. If anybody have any questions they want to ask God about this, or Bill?
He worked with us when we were cleaning out down behind the high school there, and he's a really hard worker, and he knows he's doing, and has a good sense of. That's right.
Yeah, the other thing is that this will kind of fall into the avenue of what he wants to be in the future. He's been studying, going ahead to try to become an environmental police officer. So this is a good step for him. He has showed up a lot of times between the Heron Run Park, and helped out down there, and helped out in the streams quite a bit, clearing things out. And would like to start a junior a junior program for the kids, and I've talked to the principal at the high school. I actually have a meeting with them Thursday night to get some particulars together and to put together a schedule of what their job description would be. So that's to come in the near future, probably within the next few weeks, and I can bring more back to the board. We'd like to have more than Jack. We'd like to have a few other kids involved in it, and they've learned a lot from the people that are here on what to do and how to do it. So it's, we're looking forward to the future to, you know, get a lot of these kids interested in the fisheries in Pembroke. So
I know there's a couple of kids that live on the other side of the dam on Cranberry Road, and they're getting to be the age where they can, you know, do some real work with us, saving and sort of caring for the fish as they go over the ladder for the past couple of years with their younger. So
yeah.
I'd like to add a few words, if I might.
Certainly.
Yeah, working with Jack over the summer, you notice what great character he has, and he'd be a great addition to the workforce, you know, cleaning up the streams, and he's got a great attitude, and I think it would be a way to introduce the town to, you know, bringing the young kids in to take over, because it's like, Rick was saying the other night, we're not going to be here forever, and somebody's going to take over the duties for, you know, the cleanups and then oversee an errand. And it's a good thing to have in the community, I think. Especially, I think, our kids required to do community service as part of their graduation.
Yes. And they can get credit at the fisheries.
That'd be one way for them to do it, you know.
Yeah.
And it's actually good for, you know, just for general trash up and stuff like that. The kids can tell the other kids, hey, come on, you know, we're going to take care of this place, and it's our resource, and, you know, I think it would work. I think it's a good program. I think we could probably get them, you know, some t-shirts and, you know, that kind of thing, and give them some, you know, small responsibilities. And of course, we'd be there to oversee any of their, you know, help with us on our cleanups and other duties that we do, accounting. It's an interesting thing. To actually go there and see what's happening with that, and how they're coming up, and, you know, how we need to take care of them to preserve them for the future and stuff like that. You know, so I think that it'd be a good beneficial program for Pembroke, you know, in the future, you know, for a long time to come. You know, full-time Heron Commissioner would probably come from that, you know, at some point. And, thanks for coming up with the idea,
though.
I think it's a great idea.
On a related note, I'm going to be meeting with the superintendent and all the school principals next week about a couple of programs, one being the MMA essay that the Habermock Elementary has been involved with the last 4 or 5 years. I know the other two elementary school principals want to get their schools involved in it, and that's for sixth graders. And then also, I've been talking to the superintendent about having a Students in Government Day program specifically for high school folks. And I'll be happy to share that concept of having a junior commissioners, and I'll bring that to the attention of the high school principal regarding that, you know, there's a movement to have the Junior Herring Fisheries Commission, and to have, you know, kids get involved in that as well. So
very good. Rick Madden.
I've worked with him also. He's a great kid. He shows real interest in this as not just to get through school and do some active work, but I think it's going to be a lifelong pursuit, especially with the Green Police. And I think it's a very good place to start. A lot of the trash we see, we pick up, tends to be something that we can do, but if you get kids doing it, then they're going to kind of police their own groups and age groups, and I think that custodial feeling that will come from the work they do will be a lifelong experience, and I think it's a great program, and I hope it just really takes off, and We know we could use the help, but I think it's the right people, and I think he's a perfect ambassador to start this program.
Excellent. Anybody have any questions? Do we want to make a motion to create a position of junior herring fishery members?
My grandson, I probably shouldn't make the motion.
Well, I'll move the proposal.
A motion by Arthur to support that proposal. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Dan, thank you. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing none?
Not voting.
Bill abstains?
Yes.
The vote is 4-0-1 abstention. Thank you very much, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Dave, thank you for your work.
Yes.
We appreciate it.
Oh, yeah, my pleasure. Thanks for appointing me last summer. It's been a year for me, but, you know, it's been a lot accomplished in a year.
Great. Well, Bill's been keeping us up to date.
Hopefully this.
We're very appreciative.
Yeah, he's on top of us, too. He keeps us up to date with what he wants us to do, too. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, while we got the town accountant here, Mike Buckley, he's here to go over the warrant with you folks.
Okay.
If you'd like to take that out of order, that'd be great.
All right. Well, we do have Mike Buckley here. And an item on our agenda is a preliminary discussion of the special town meeting warrant, a review of the routine articles, and vote articles for inclusion only. Next week, we will discuss those articles in more detail, and we will have questions, I'm sure.
Well, Mr. Chairman, if anybody's got a question tonight about that, you know, just notify Mike and I, and we'll have the answers for the board next Monday, because next Monday is when you'll be, Sabrina, correct me if I'm wrong, but next Monday is when they make recommendations on these?
It'll begin with the routine articles if everyone's in agreement, yes.
So we'll begin, of course, with Article 1, and this is a list that has been submitted to us from different departments to purchase various pieces of equipment. And do we have any... Is this going to be an article where we would want to have additional questions on for next week? Or does anyone have a question for Mike on any of this? So I don't...
Mike, what's the appropriate... What's the estimate price tag for Article 1?
It's in the $820,000 range.
And that's free cash, borrowing?
Water surplus.
Thanks.
Okay. Moving on, Article 2 is a routine article, and it's for separation pay benefits, and I believe Mike has got $250,000 plugged into that.
I do. That appropriation is down to $50,000 from a high of $330,000.
So it's 50,000?
The balance today.
The balance today is 50. Okay. Article number 3 is another routine, adding additional money to our stabilization fund. You have an amount for that, Mike?
$25,000.
We have $1.3 million in there now. So it's
continually
in progress. Yeah. I'd just like to ask the board that as we go through these articles, if anyone feels that we shouldn't have an article here, please identify that as we go through. And if there's going to be any future questions, I can also write that down. Article 4 is another routine item, which will be in order to reduce to balance the budget, and you got a number on that, Mike, I believe.
That is $537,347. That is to close the books on fiscal 16 and take the last year's snow days.
Question, Dan?
Right, this is a question for the finance folks in town as much as for the DPW, but there are some folks in town that questioned, we had recently purchased extra machinery so that the town employees could do our own plowing, a major portion of it. So what portion of this 537 is for our own workforce as opposed to subbing out the snow and ice from last year? It's an important question that people want to know because we invested a lot of money into equipment recently. So having done that in a fairly mild winter, people just want to know the percentages. How much did we do on our own, and how much did we sub out?
We'll have the breakdown for you next Monday night.
Right. Thank you.
Good. Excellent. Okay, Article 5 is another one that's established as a routine item, post-employee benefit liability fund, and you've got a number on that, Mike.
$250,000 on that.
Any issues or questions on 5? Article 6 is another routine article. This is has to do with the budget from last year.
Actually, that's this year's budget. Kathleen refunded, is the term we use, the debt for the junior high school and high school. And she got a great rate, and we are able to reduce the fiscal 17 budget, and subsequently the debt is added to the tax rate, the debt exclusion, fiscal 17 as well. That information wasn't available in May when we put the budget together, but it's available now.
Any idea what the amount's going to be?
It's right now in the high threes, low fours.
So in other words, this is something that we budget every year. When you look at the general fund budget, there is categories for maturing debt interest, maturing debt principal, and there are line items for the school budgets for paying off the debt on what we paid to renovate those schools. And correct me if I'm wrong, but that's exactly what it's going to do. It's going to reduce that amount by $300,000-$400,000.
Right, and therefore the tax rate, and therefore people's tax bills would be that much lower than they otherwise would be.
Okay.
That's all good.
Article 7 is to provide a sum of money to cover job injuries to town employees. You got a number there, Mike?
I have $50,000. That is part of the Governor's Municipal Modernization Act. It allows the towns to more easily set aside money so that they can build up reserves to become self-insured. Can't do that in a year, of course, but if we do that over time, we're going to save ourselves a lot of money. So I'm recommending we start that with $50,000.
Article 8 is the article that would cover collective bargaining agreements that will be finalized. Do you have anything to say about that?
Well, I mean, I think depending on the actions of the selectmen in executive session tonight, we could have a number for Article 8 next Monday night.
Okay.
Quick,
Dan.
Just a question of the use of the term routine for that here. Is that appropriate?
Well, it's on every town meeting warrant.
The contract itself is a routine, but the fact that we have it on the warrant, every special is.
That's fair enough.
Okay. Article 9 is $50,000. For drainage construction for the Route 14 project. And I have a question on that. Can I get a quick explanation of another $50,000 for that? Is this something that came up at the last minute? Well, let's leave that for next week, and we'll investigate.
Definitely an answer on that.
We'll investigate.
I'm like you, Mr. Chairman. I thought that we had taken care of it, so this might have been something that might have been submitted by the DPW.
And it would, if I could further that, it'd be helpful if you could have a tally of what the town has spent or projects to spend.
Sure.
And to balance that out, what the state expects to spend. The more information we can get out to the public, the better it is.
Now, Article 10 is to transfer some available funds that are carried over from the Pembroke's 300 activity fund. And the selectmen would have the authority to use that money with a vote of the board to support future townwide celebrations and commemorations. What is the dollar value there?
It's about $18,000.
$18,000. Okay.
I thought it was more appropriate to put that in the control of the selectmen than a committee that was had accomplished its task.
Now, Article 11 is the new proposed bylaw that would regulate folks coming before this board looking for a permit to go house to house to solicit business. As the board knows, we've been for it, we have not been for it, so it was time to take a look at that whole situation, and there's a very lengthy new bylaw that I think we can take the time to read that between now and next week, and we can answer any questions that may come up. We're just trying to tighten up the rules so that folks who are not happy having that happen can get some protection, and the folks that don't have any issues with it, the people are still going to be able to come before this board. So. Part of that would be Article 13, that would be the police department will be involved in that bylaw. They will have some responsibilities that they don't currently have. And
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
You're one step ahead of the
I skipped
chart
one?
Here. So 12 is next.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Now 12.
Yeah,
12 and 13 almost go hand in hand. One
correct.
Is the proposed
right.
bylaw
mine,
for
mine is missing 11.
Revolving fund to support it.
What bill?
Missing 11 on here.
I'm missing 11?
Front page.
It's because it's...
Is it,
yeah. Yeah.
Right. Well, don't worry about the front page. Worry about the actual warrant itself.
Right. Right.
Sorry, yeah, the Articles 12 and 13 go together. Article 12 is the chief's proposed bylaw amendment outlining the civil fingerprinting regulations. And Article 13 is the revolving fund that he would like to establish
right.
to support.
You need to establish a revolving fund for the police department.
Yeah, this new bylaw is a very complex one, and it's very lengthy, but we wanted to cover all issues and questions. And I think we have, but that's up for discussion. Article 14 is a space and needs feasibility study for the DPW at a cost of $30,000. I have a question on that. I'd like to get some more information on just what this is going to entail. Mm-hmm. I don't have any idea what this study is going to study.
Well, we'll have the DPW here next week.
Excellent. I think that would be a good idea. They can come and tell us why this is so important to them. Article 15 is from the school committee, and they would like to install a new track and turf field at Pembroke High School. And the cost of that would be $1.2 million. And the proposal is to finance that through a 20-year debt exclusion. And I have questions on that one as well.
I would expect that the board would like to have the school committee in attendance.
I would ask if you would invite them to answer some issues about that. Article 16 is, this is to set the salaries and wages of town employees that are not covered under collective bargaining agreements or by the school committee. So we would...
I'll have a recommendation for the board next week.
Excellent. Article 17 is to approve a 10-year lease between the town and the Lydia Drake Library trustees for the use of the Lydia Drake Library on High Street. We have been doing this, according to the explanation, for as long as 14 years. And the trustees are responsible for the operation of the Lydia Drake Library.
For the board's information, 14 years ago, the library divested themselves from anything to do with the Lydia Drake Library. So we created a separate small budget for them and created the library trustees so that it wasn't under the direction of the library board of directors. The library board of trustees and the library director herself. So basically it was part of the library system until the new library was built some time ago, and then, like I said, the then librarian, head library director, and the board of trustees, like I said, divested themselves to that library, that building.
Right, and for several years, the folks running the library would come into town meeting and ask for money to help fund them.
Mm-hmm.
And after a few years of that, we have a line item for it.
Correct.
Could you tell us for this specific 10-year lease request, if there's a dollar value associated with it?
Well, right now we don't have a dollar value on it, but you'll have it next Monday night.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and that's for the lease itself, not
correct.
The funding of the
well, I
general
think it's
expenses.
Going to be part and parcel.
Are they?
The lease is going to be part of the. Yeah.
Okay, next Monday night. Thank mm-hmm. you.
Very good. Article 18 is the Community Preservation Committee's articles that they have every year. We have several of them. One is for $25,000 for a building study of the Pembroke Community Center.
Mr. Chairman, what they're doing is that they're actually taking $25,000 from that funding in FY13 and transferring it to their fund reserve.
Okay.
So it's money that they don't need in that particular line item, and they're transferring it to their fund reserve. That's what A is all about.
Okay, so it's not, they're not asking to spend that money?
No, they're asking to transfer it.
Transfer it, okay. Thank you for that explanation. And our recommendation B is to transfer $25,000 to the fund reserve and $35,000 to the community housing reserve, totaling $60,000. That was approved at the special town meeting in 2014 for a Pembroke Housing Authority site design project.
Same thing, it's going back to the fund reserve.
Exactly. Okay. Same thing as A.
Yeah, just a question on that. What happened with that? Because we got a new Housing Authority director and we had a lot of hope that there was some action taken, and are we slowing down on that action now? Is that what this article...
Yeah, and if we need the director to be in and say why that thing slowed down, that'd be fine.
Okay.
Yeah, I think that would be a good idea, Dan, to have him come
in. So I think it was his idea to start off with.
It was. Yeah. It was his idea. Right. He came in... you know, with a lot of great ideas and a lot of hope and a lot of enthusiasm. So I'm just, I'd like to know if that enthusiasm has waned, or is it just a matter of the way the wheels of municipal government turn, it's so slow.
Well, I think that was part of his design project to expand the number of units. So why that didn't occur, it's strictly up to Mr. McEwen to tell us why.
Right.
Recommendation C is appropriate $55,800 from the reserve fund, and those funds granted to the trustees of the First Church for phase two of an ongoing restoration and replacement of pillars, trim, windows, and shutters. Any questions on that? Recommendation D is to appropriate $100,000 from the Open Space Recreation Reserve, $115,000 from the Fund Reserve, and that the total of $215,000 be granted to the town of Pembroke for the purchase of 5 acres of land at 369 Washington Street for open space historical preservation purposes, and to include preservation of existing real estate on the parcel with new parking. So this is, you want to explain that, Ed?
Yeah, this pays for the acquisition of the Benson property, because about 5 acres of that 10 acres is going to be open space. There's only going to be, it's open space now. Can't be built on because it's all wetlands, but the Open Space Committee and the Community Preservation Committee saw fit that they would help the town purchase that land at the corner of 14 and 53.
So the original purchase price that we've agreed to will actually be reduced by this amount of money?
Correct. In fact, there's a thought that the Springtown meeting may also allocate an additional amount of money on that and our project.
Dan?
I have a question. So we bought the property for $820,000. The town's paying $820,000 no matter which fund it comes out of. So we understand that. But this article right here, does that pigeonhole the use of that land?
Absolutely.
The usual upland of that land.
There is no upland.
And what about the mention of the building on the property? So preservation of the existing real estate on the parcel. Mm-hmm. Does that mean that that building is going to be protected by the town by use of these funds?
Well, it's going to be protected anyway. That was the intent of that. But both the proposed municipal use and the existing Turner House are all on wetlands, on upland not affected by this 5-acre allocation to open space.
Okay, I got to see more about this. I am for the use of community preservation funds to assist with the property, but I want to make sure that we don't pigeonhole ourselves by cutting off a prime piece of the property, because you know our original intent was, it was hopes to maybe perhaps one day put a fire station there, but whether that happens or not, I don't want to pigeonhole this property for the sake of using some community preservation funds.
We'll be happy to show you a map that shows the wetlands delineation that's already been delineated by Merrill Associates, and so that's already been confirmed by the Conservation Commission, and that's why the Conservation Commission agreed with the Community Preservation about acquiring this for open space. But we'll be happy to share with the board next Monday night a map showing the property and showing the wetlands delineation, so that you know that nothing could be built on the 5 acres that's being set aside for open space.
Okay, well, that's fine. But also I want to make sure that the house that's on here doesn't impede the full use of this land either.
Sure, absolutely.
Okay, recommendation E is to appropriate $4,200, to install on-deck cages at Field Day at the Mattakeesett Street baseball fields. And recommendation F is to appropriate $9,200 granted to Pembroke Youth Baseball to replace fencing on Field Day at the Mattakeesett Street ball fields. Questions on that? Okay. So if anyone has any other questions or would like to recommend eliminating any of these articles, I have not heard that. So we will assume that the warrant that's in front of us will be the one that we'll be discussing next week in more detail. Thank you, Mike. Anybody have any questions for Mike before he leaves? Hearing none. Thank you, Mike, for coming by. So we've taken a few things out of order, but if everybody agrees, why don't we just go back to the beginning? And the first action item is to consider the appointment of Pamela Blades to the vacancy on the Council on Aging Board at the request of the board chairman.
Move the appointment of Pamela Blades at 44 Warren Terrace to the Council on Aging Board of Directors.
Motion by Arthur.
Second.
Second by Bill. Any questions? Hearing none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Hearing none, I deem it unanimously. The second item on our action list is the resignation of Daniel Taylor from the Town Government Study Committee.
Move to accept with regrets.
Motion by Dan to
second.
Accept with regret. Second by Arthur.
Yeah.
Any questions?
Just a note. Upon accepting this resignation, there is one more seat open on the Town Government Study Committee, and that committee has found some new life and some new vigor. So I wish anyone that's interested to please join.
Okay. So we have a motion and we have a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing none, I deem it unanimous. So we have taken care of the warrant. The Copperwood Circle project, we were going to discuss tonight. A request has been made to postpone that discussion for 1 week. So next Monday night, we will have Copperwood Circle project. The hauling route is the question for us. And so we will have that on the agenda.
Question.
Yes.
When will the Conservation Commission be hearing discussion on that?
Tonight.
I wish we could get a message over to them that we had a discussion on this hauling route last week, and it's the Conservation Commission's purview to discuss, and if there's any mitigation to the town, I would just like to see the Conservation Commission move forward with this new hauling route for benefit of the citizens, but it's a great benefit to the developer. So I would like to see the Conservation Commission reach out and try to receive some mitigation from the developer if possible. I mean, something as simple as funding a DARE officer for the year. I think they should reach out and ask for some sort of mitigation. And float that idea.
The conservation agent and I had a long discussion about that before I went out of town, and they are meeting with Copperwood tonight, and I believe that in my conversations with the conservation agent, I told them that it would be in the best interest of the town that they hear and they discuss mitigation with them, and that we would, he and I would meet this week and discuss what they are going to propose before any decisions made about any agreement, because we're going to have a written agreement signed with the developer about, as Matthew suggested last week, about the restoration of any vegetation that's going to occur. So anyway, I don't think that there's going to be a decision made by conservation tonight. They are fully aware of the ZBA's decision that was made regarding the truck route and also mitigation costs. The decision says that the developer would donate $10,000 to the town for improvements to the Birch Street Park. So building upon that, I think that the Conservation Commission, you know, one of the things that they're going to be talking about are mitigation arrangements, and I think that, that might be something that will be before this board next Monday night.
So, thank you.
Thank you, Ed. Yes, Arthur.
I just want to note, I think Dan's suggestion is an excellent one. I think that, you know, to get a DARE program back in the schools is important. I think we are potentially giving a lot away by allowing them to cross the property where they're going to cross it. And I don't think it's too much to ask that they do something for the town in return. So I think Dan's suggestion is an excellent one.
Yes, I agree, Arthur. Speaking of the CBA's decision on this project, Ed is right that they do have a condition in here: prior to the issuance of any building permit, the applicant shall deliver $10,000 to the town of Pembroke, earmarked for the maintenance and improvement of the Birch Street playground. Also, during construction, all construction vehicles carrying fill to the project shall only be allowed to access between 9 a.m. and 4 p.m. Monday through Friday, and all such construction vehicles shall enter and exit the project site via Birch Street from Route 53 and shall not enter or exit via Pelham Street. Well, that last part we're going to be taking care of with a new agreement. But as the board knows, when people move fill in this town, they come before the selectmen to get a permit. And we set days and hours. But under a 40B program, the ZBA is the authority. So they have established Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. And with this new route, we will be complying, and actually it would be better for the neighborhood. So I think when we meet with them, we'll just keep in mind when we get a bus schedule from them that Monday through Friday, 9 to 4 is what has been established. Okay, thank you. Can I have a motion on the minutes of September 12th?
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to move to table the minutes for 1 week. There's some verbiage in here that that I'd like to speak with Sabrina about before these minutes are just voted on.
Second.
Good. Dan has a proposal to postpone these minutes for 1 week.
I have a second.
Arthur has seconded that motion. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing none, we'll make that unanimous. So we'll take up the minutes of September 12th next week. Now, we kind of went ahead a little bit at the beginning of this meeting, and there was, under old business, there was a couple of issues, and I know Dan had one. Would you like to take that up at this time, Dan?
Right. Under old business, there's actually two items, one that I'm bringing up, and I expect Arthur will bring up something, both to do with letters. I met with the town administrator to draft a letter to the Board of Assessors, and Ed, what is the status of that letter now? It's been distributed to us through, via email. Is that ready to present for vote tonight?
Ready, yeah.
Yeah, this came from a citizen's request, and if you haven't had a chance to read it in the email that was distributed to us, read it out loud right now. September 19th, 2016, Town Pembroke Board of Assessors, 100 Center Street, Pembroke, Mass. Dear Ms. Bates, Bodie, and Quill, Pembroke Board of Selectmen's office would like to request a detailed set of instructions and criteria that would provide a roadmap of exactly what a private property owner would need to do to obtain property tax exemption as a nature preserve. A resident has recently voiced concerns about preserving the town's natural heritage for all future generations to enjoy, stating that natural land provides many benefits to our residents, including preservation of open space, wildlife habitat, recreation, nature education, clean water and air, spiritual enrichment, etc. A resident further states that the assessor's office provided Wildlands Trust property tax exemption on their Willowbrook Preserve property and has requested that the Board of Selectmen assist in obtaining the instructions and criteria required for a property tax exemption as a nature preserve. So I'm trying to help this resident by the Board of Selectmen reaching out, just looking for the criteria. I would like to know myself, and I would like to be able to pass that information along to the resident so that he knows and understands, and that way he can move forward with knowledge. It's really as simple as that. It's just looking for some information. So that, we've all had an opportunity to read it, an email, but in case you didn't have a chance to read it today, that's why I read it out loud just now. So that's the letter before us, and Mr. Chairman, I would move that the Board of Selectmen accept this letter and forward it to the Board of Assessors.
Motion by Dan to accept this letter as he has written to be forwarded to the Board of Assessors. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Bill. Any further discussion or comments from the board?
Yeah, I'll be voting present because I could potentially, by nature of what I do for a living, be called in to be a witness in an action, if there is one, by the board or by the citizen.
So you'll be abstaining?
Yes.
Any other discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor of sending to the Board of Assessors this letter that Dan has just read, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Hearing none, there's one abstention. So I would rule that was four in favor and one abstention.
Thank you. And if you're still under old business.
Yes.
Do you want me to pass this to you, Arthur?
I've got a copy.
Oh, you do? Okay.
Thank you. We had agreed last week that Ed and I would get together and address a letter to the new Board of Health member, Gail McSweeney, and I've written to her. It's come to the attention of the Board of Selectmen that the Board of Health is contributing disproportionately to the town's legal costs, and we've also noticed that there has been a need for a police detail at several of the meetings. We as a board have had a number of public discussions regarding a perceived agenda and are requesting that you focus on the Board of Health business at hand rather than items that have passed, in some instances, over 6 years old. We are concerned that the public is not being well served by your personal goals, and we request that you reevaluate your position on and focus on issues that will best serve the residents of the town of Pembroke.
Move that we accept that letter and send it to him.
Second.
Motion by Bill to accept this letter, and second by Arthur. Any questions? Any other discussion?
I have a comment.
I'm sorry. Yes, Matthew.
I think that was very well written, and it really sends a message without being too strong.
Thank you.
Good. Thank you. All those in favor of sending this letter please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing none, I deem it unanimous. Thank you. Town administrators report?
Mr. Chairman, I already mentioned my meeting with the school officials regarding programs that interact with town government and the schools.
Okay.
I'm actually meeting with that principal Thursday morning.
Pardon?
I said I'm actually meeting with the principal Thursday morning.
Oh, okay.
So he'll have a heads up before you see him.
Do we have anything under Ask the Selectmen from any selectmen? Hearing none, down to new business. Anyone have any new business they want to bring up?
I do, if you deem it appropriate. We got good news as a town today, and in particular, the McSherry family, Christine McSherry, who has been the voice in the face of the Jet Foundation and the this advocating for the safe and effective treatment for Duchenne's muscular dystrophy. Their drug that was 5 years in the making in terms of becoming a legal accepted drug by the FDA was accepted today. So they are, I'm sure, celebrating, and they would like the residents of Pembroke to get a thank you from them. And they stated they literally wouldn't be here without the contributions of the townspeople. And it's, you know, it's a major step, and, you know, it may have saved a life. So we should send out our congratulations to the McSherry family, and Christine McSherry in particular, for her founding of the Jet Foundation and the work that she did, along with a myriad of volunteers here in the community and from outside the community as well. As people know, they made trips to Washington, D.C. They got help from our congressional and Senate representatives and our local reps as well. So it's a bright day for the Jet Foundation.
That's excellent. Excellent.
Yeah, it's hard to have a bad day after that.
Yeah, right. So we'll agree to put together a letter.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea.
I think so.
Good idea.
So we'll have that as a motion. Send a letter to the McSherry, seconded by Bill. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing none, that's unanimous. So, would you like to be involved with that, Arthur?
Yeah, I'll get with Sabrina and, you know, put something together.
That's a great idea.
Yeah. I'm glad you thought of it.
Mr. Chairman, while you're talking about new business, it is kind of old business and new business, but I attended the meeting of the Central Plymouth County Water District Commission last week. We had more discussion about the diversion of water from Mont Ponset Lakes and also from Furnace Pond and Oldham Pond. And there was a scheduled meeting coming up very soon to meet at the State House with the state representatives of those districts. And hopefully we can start the ball rolling in the State House by involving everybody up there to let them know that we mean business to try to do something about this. Ponds are really taking a big hit in this area, so I'm kind of really hoping that that meeting at the State House, which I plan on attending, will be fruitful. So I'll let you.
That's great.
Let you know what's going on when it happens. So,
hey, Bill, for you and everyone else too, this Saturday at 10 a.m. there's a forum on the watershed and Brockton's use of water through the watershed. So Tom Calter, Josh Cutler, and some other folks are going to speak. Pine Dubois will be one of the speakers. So it'll be an informational forum. With some input from the crowd and the community. It's 10 a.m. this Saturday, and I...
Is that the boat ramp?
At the boat ramp.
At Halifax.
There it is.
Yeah.
It's on Route 58.
Yep. So if you're interested, that'd be a great forum to take in.
Yeah, not that we've had to consider it in the last several months, but when we get a rain date. Do they have a place to hold it inside if this?
I don't know.
I don't think so.
No, I don't think they mentioned that at all, that consideration.
For your rain.
Yeah, hasn't been a consideration for several months.
They will have refreshments, Bill.
That's good.
That's good, that's a good thing. Okay, upcoming issues. On September 26th, Sun Edison, TRC Solutions, and the Solar Landfill Project Introduction. A group will be coming before us to give us a detailed information on where this project stands and what the schedule going forward is going to be. So I'm very interested in hearing that, as I know the board is, next Monday night. October 18th at 7 p.m. is the date for the special town meeting. Are there any other issues that the board would like to bring up? Hearing none, we have a need for executive session.
Mr. Chairman, I would move that we enter executive session for to discuss strategy with respect to collective bargaining or litigation. If an open meeting may have a detrimental effect on the bargaining or litigating position of the public body in the chair, so declares, and it's regarding police and fire.
Motion by Arthur. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Bill. All those in favor by roll call. Dan?
Yes.
Matthew?
Yes.
Bill?
Yes.
Arthur?
Yes.
And I vote yes. I don't believe we have any plans to come back in public session after executive session is over. And I'd like to remind the public that the next regularly scheduled meeting of the Board of Selectmen is Monday, September 26th at 7 p.m. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next week.